If you need a quick, easy way to complete your export documents, submit your EEI filings, and stay compliant with U.S. export regulations, then Shipping Solutions software is for you. Stay tuned for a quick overview of how the software works, and subscribe to this channel for more videos sharing practical advice for exporters and importers. Welcome to Shipping Solutions Export Documentation and Compliance Software. With Shipping Solutions, you can dramatically reduce the time it takes to complete your export forms, file through AES, and run your compliance screenings. So let's get started. This is the Shipping Solutions main menu. Here you'll see our phone number. Customer support is very important to us, so please call us with any questions you have. The Easy Start tab is where you will create your shipments, but first, let's click on the Databases tab. Here's where you can store your company, customer, and product information so that you don't have to retype it every time you create a shipment. This saves time and makes sure the information is consistent every time you do a shipment. Let's look at the Contacts database. On the Exporter screen, you can store your company information. Once it is entered here, it will never have to be typed on your export documents again. You can store your customers, known as ultimate consignees, in the contacts database, as well as bill to, freight forwarder, and intermediate consignee addresses. You can enter these contacts manually, or you can go to the Tools tab and upload your customer list. But let's go back to the Databases tab and look at the Products database. Here you can store your product information, such as product ID, product description, and unit price, so you don't have to enter it each time you ship that item to a customer, which will save you time on your export paperwork. You can also store the information needed for filing through AES Direct, which can be done through Shipping Solutions, or for printing an SLI for your forwarder to file on your behalf. And you can store the information needed for free trade agreements. On this tab, you can store State Department license information, and on this tab, you can store dangerous goods information. Click this button to access the IATA database of dangerous goods to look up your UN number and proper shipping name. Now let's go to the Easy Start screen to create a shipment. You can create a shipment by copying a previous shipment or by importing an order from your accounting or ERP system using the Shipping Solutions Data Exchange Manager, which I'll discuss a little later. But for this example, let's create a shipment by clicking the New button. You should always enter information on the Contacts and Product Details screens. After that, just pick and choose the screens that relate to the particular documents you need for your shipment. So let's start by clicking on Contacts and entering the parties to the shipment. Exporter is first, and because my company information is entered on the Databases tab we looked at earlier, I can click Add Contact from Database, find my exporter information, and click Add Contact. You can also set a default value for your exporter, and I'll show you how to do that in a minute. But to add my customer or ultimate consignee, I click on Ultimate Consignee, Add Contact from Database, find it in my list, and click Add Contact. I can keep adding the contacts that I need. Let's add an intermediate consignee. Many more contact types are available by right-clicking in this box and choosing Add Contact, and there you can see the additional contacts that you can add to this shipment. When I'm done, I click Save and Close. Next, let's enter the products in this shipment on the Product Details screen. Because I have products entered on the Databases tab we looked at earlier, I can click Add from Database, select the items that I want to add to this shipment, and then click Add Selected Products to Shipment. All the information I have stored in the Products database will fill in on the Product Details screen. I can enter my sales quantity, and I will do that for both items that I added to this shipment. I can also change the information on this screen. So I pulled in the standard price, but if this particular customer has a special price, I can change it here, and the extended price will recalculate, and it won't change the value that's stored in the database. And when I'm done, I can click Save and Close. Now that I've entered my contacts and products, I can move down through the screens, stopping only on the documents I need. Most shipments need an invoice, so let's click the Invoices screen. If I don't need a pro forma invoice, I can skip this top section, but since I need a commercial invoice, I'll stop here and fill in the required information. So I'll put in a date, a commercial invoice number. There's also a spot to include phrases or special instructions, and I can store those in a database so that when I come here, I can just pick them out of the drop-down list. I'll enter an order number and a PO number. I'll enter my terms, and you can add additional payment terms to the payment terms database, and then they'll display in the drop-down list. I can choose my Incoterm year, my Incoterm, add the location, and then I can also enter any freight or handling fees. Shipping Solutions always defaults to US dollars, but it allows you to choose a different currency for your invoice if you need to. You can choose a signature here or set a default signature on your profile that will always print on your invoices. Then click Save and Close. To view or print the commercial invoice, you click the Preview Print Email button. Then choose Commercial Invoice and click Preview. As you can see, the information that we entered is here, and I've also added a company logo and signature to this document. I can print the document from here, or I can return to the Preview Print Email screen and print one or more copies, print to PDF, or email the document. With Shipping Solutions, you can quickly and easily produce all of the standard export forms and print them out on plain paper. As you can see, the list includes certificates of origin, invoices, dangerous goods documents, bills of lading, a packing list, and many others. And you can do more than create export documents with Shipping Solutions. I'll close this screen and go back to the Easy Start screen. So clicking on this button, the AES button, allows you to file with AES Direct without retyping any of your export information. A login to the ACE portal is provided right within the software. And once you are logged in, you can upload your shipment information to AES Direct. Click on the Compliance button to access the Export Compliance module, where you can determine what documents are needed for your shipment, determine if any of your products require an export license, and screen the parties in your shipment against the government's restricted parties lists. An audit trail of all the screenings you ran is kept right with the shipment in case you are ever audited by the Office of Export Enforcement or some other agency. You can then show them that you did your due diligence by running these screenings. Click the Utilities tab to generate reports or print shipping labels. The Generate Reports screen lets you create Excel spreadsheets of your shipment data, which can also be helpful for audit purposes. On the Tools tab, you can do things like backup your database, lock shipments that are completed, and customize your documents. In addition to importing your customer and product lists, which we discussed earlier, you can also export them. The Admin tab is where you can set up the Data Exchange Manager so that you can import orders from your accounting or ERP system, saving even more time. The Data Exchange Manager can import from text files or an XML file, or you can set up and use an ODBC connection. On this tab, you can also add signatures and logos, set up user groups with varying levels of security, and add user profiles so that each user can store what is needed for their shipment, such as their own signature. You can also use this global settings feature to set up defaults for some of the fields. For example, I'll click here, and here is where you can enter your exporter information so that every time you click the New button on the Easy Start screen, your exporter information will automatically be added. In this video, I have just scratched the surface of what Shipping Solutions can do to make your export documentation process faster and more accurate. For more information, give us a call at 888-890-7447 or visit our website at shippingsolutions.com to request a live demonstration of the software. Thank you for watching.
Thanks for watching. If you liked this video, we'd appreciate it if you'd like it and share it, and subscribe to our channel for more videos sharing real practical advice for exporters and importers. You'll also find hundreds of articles about every aspect of exporting at shippingsolutions.com/blog. Check below for a link.